Hi, you guys. Lindsay here. I hope that you all have been enjoying the StyleMaker Fabrics spring blog tour. I know that I have. There's been a lot of amazing outfits on there. If you haven't seen mine, it went live on Saturday, and you can watch that video obviously here on YouTube. But today what I wanted to do was kind of do a follow-up to the swatch video that I did last week. I had asked a bunch of you guys if you wanted me to wash some of them and kind of show you the differences and what would happen to them after they got washed. So I thought it would be a fun experiment, to say the least. What I basically did was took the regular swatch, cut it in half, and washed one half of them. So we will have like a before and after. But I did want to address some of the questions that I brought up in the swatch video about a couple of the fabrics. One of them was this palm fabric here. Remember, I was like, I can't tell if this is just fading because it's on the selvage or what is going on. So Michelle says that the palm leaves aren't really ombre. It's more all over, but the background definitely changes colors in different areas. She says it's really pretty. It would be perfect for a robe, kimono, or cover-up, and she was definitely thinking beachy since it would dry quickly. She said it's great for traveling, and they have it in a few colors, and that it was designed in Hawaii. So you can see here that it's dark blue, and then this part of the background is almost more green. And she said that's totally on purpose, and it's like that kind of more... I guess less randomly on a big piece of fabric than it is on just this little swatch. So I wanted to let y'all know that. And then regarding this stuff called bubble gauze, remember I was like, bubble gauze, what's that? I'd heard of regular gauze before, but never bubble gauze. And she had said that bubble gauze is a term in the fabric industry for the crinkle gauze that is a single layer. She says, she thinks the term bubble comes from the bubbly texture, almost like paint bubbles or something when it is laid flat. So you can see the texture here, and that's all it is. It's just a single layer of crinkle gauze. So there you have it. Answers on bubble gauze. What else? Okay, so there is one of them in here that we went over that she wanted to address too. She said that sometimes whenever they have... fabrics that have really large scale prints to them, they'll cut a long skinny swatch like this so that you can get an idea of the scale and get all or most of the colors that are included in the fabric. She said this one would make the coolest pants, specifically cotton sateen. So, and we'll go over what happened to that fabric after it got washed in a moment. Okay, now that that is out of the way, let's get started on the swatches. Okay, so this one is 11223. It's the Rayon Crepe Heavyweight in Solid Black. So what I wanted to know about this, Rayon Crepe can be pretty light, but she says this is a heavyweight version. So I wanted to know what happened after it washed. This is the after the washing stack. And what I can say honestly is that not much changed at all. If anything, it's a little bit softer. I do not have any reference on which is the front or which is the right side and which is the back side anymore because I didn't think to mark that. But I can tell you that it's just the weight has stayed the same, and it's just as stretchy and just as lovely. Like I said, if anything, it's softer, which is really, really nice. So again, 11223 on that. This one was numbered 11133. And it is just a cotton shirting, 100% cotton. So I did some of these cotton ones because sometimes they can shrink a ton and sometimes they unravel a bunch on the edges. So I wanted to compare that. So you can see here that the shrinkage was really fairly minimal. I mean, I didn't cut these exactly like with a ruler and stuff, but you can see there's really only a little bit of shrinkage along the selvage edge. I'm pretty sure that's the selvage edge. So that's good. And it didn't really unravel much. It did soften up a bunch. It even became like a little bit more drapey. You can see this one, it almost feels like now it has a coating on it, whereas this is just completely raw cotton. It feels just like 100% cotton. So yeah, this one did really great in the wash, I feel like. I don't like a super crisp cotton sometimes, especially in springtime dresses. I like them to be a little bit more organic. So that's what you'll get with this. Okay, this one is a linen. And if you saw my video on Saturday, you know that I made a linen jacket. This is not the same linen. That is going to come later, but you get the idea. A lot of the linens will unravel. This one isn't doing that bad of a job, but you do see like there's a lot of unraveling going on the edges there. And shrinkage wise, it did shrink pretty significantly, almost an inch. So keep that in mind whenever you are ordering your fabric. The feel of the fabric, yeah, there's like a almost like a really smooth texture to this, and it's all gone. This feels like raw linen. It feels pretty nice and smooth on the areas that don't have the print on it. Whereas on the original one, it kind of feels the same all the way across. Now you can tell a difference and where it was like stamped or printed with this pattern. So this one is 11125. Still really great quality linen. I'm obsessed with my jacket, by the way. Cool. Okay, this one, I remember thinking, gosh, this is like just like a sheet of paper. It has no drape, it has nothing, it doesn't do anything whenever you hold on to it. So I was really interested to see what would happen to it. 11122, it is a stretch sateen. And quite honestly, like not a lot happened to it. It's still pretty much stiff as a board. It did shrink a little bit. Let's see. Yeah, just the teeniest bit. But like the stretch is still there. It's only minimal. This, you know, honestly would make really great shorts. It's very structured. I mean, nothing really gives with this. So, you know, yeah, I think some really great shorts are in order, or like, you know, pencil pants or something like that. But yeah, really surprised that like it didn't, I don't know what I was expecting from this, because this one felt so strange to me being so stiff. But this isn't really all that different. It's, you know, kind of a lot like denim. It's stretch sateen. I think it might be twill weave, because it does look like there's a diagonal weave going on, but I don't know. It doesn't say that, so I don't want to speak to it too much. But yeah, so this would make really great, this is a good bottom weight fabric, I think. Okay, next up, this was the jacquard that I am still obsessed with. And interestingly enough, the texture came out so much more after I washed it. So if you can see here, the texture is really subtle, right? It's like pretty much pressed flat as if you ironed it. And on this one, you can see all of the texture in there. It's like the texture became raised and just became even more pronounced, which is awesome, I think. It did shrink quite a bit, if we want to lay these together, on both ways, selvage edge and otherwise, and the other way. So, you know, obviously keep that in mind. I think these are 6-inch squares to start. I believe that's right. So yeah, keep the shrinkage in mind. But yeah, I feel like the color is still just as vibrant, but the texture is the biggest change in this. It's honestly even more amazing. Feel wise, well, the texture jumps out to me whenever I'm feeling it. It still feels just as soft, just as drapey. Maybe a teensy bit softer over here, but the biggest difference is the texture. That's so cool. I never would have guessed that. Love it. Okay, look at this one. Okay, so this was the denim 11055. The floral stretch denim print in blue. And you remember, I was like obsessing over this becoming a denim jacket whenever I first saw it. I thought it'd be the coolest denim jacket. P.S. Did anyone see Alina's new denim jacket pattern? Alina Design Company. You have to go check that out. But this is what happened to it after you washed it. It became a lot more like chambray then it feels like denim. It's got some more drape to it. It's definitely softer. And after seeing it like this, now I'm thinking, collared shirt dress. I'm thinking a sheath dress, something along those lines, because it isn't nearly as structured as I was thinking it was whenever I saw it unwashed. Afterwards, it became a lot softer. And the shrinkage was actually pretty significant, maybe half an inch on a 6-inch piece. So keep that in mind. And the colors, they look a lot different because this is more of what's happening right here. That's just the part of the swatch that is right here. So this is this area and this blue is this background area. So, I mean, the colors did fade a little bit, but not too much. Okay, so this is the linen that I used for my jacket, 11036. Linen blend shirting, and actually I lie, it's not. She has the linen, so the linen I used was a textured linen, but she has it in the same color as this. And I don't think that they are the same, but look at all that raveling that happened. I mean, half of the thing is basically gone now because of all that raveling. So if you do pick up one of these linens, I highly recommend you serging the edges first, or treating them in some way before you throw them in the wash to preserve a lot of that yardage. Otherwise, you're going to lose like half your yardage just for the unraveling on the edges. But in terms of the fabric itself, it's like super soft. It washed up super soft. And again, the texture is more pronounced. This feels really smooth, whereas this feels more like linen. So that's really cool. And I also feel like the colors changed a little bit. This one feels a little bit lighter, a little bit less. I was about to say less beige, but that makes no sense since it's clearly like a neutral color. But yeah, I feel like it's just a teensy bit lighter in color. I don't even know if you can tell on camera or not, but definitely softer. Drapiness is, you know, kind of about the same. And yeah, it's just softer and the texture is different. So that's cool. This one was one of my favorites from the video, 11107. This one was one of my favorites from the video, 11107. It's a jersey knit dot cream. And it's like 100% stretch. I mean, it's literally so stretchy and the recovery is amazing. So I wanted to see what happened after you washed it. You can tell, yes, it shrunk a lot. I mean, look at how much that shrunk by. That's amazing. That's like 3/4 of an inch, maybe half an inch there. Because probably it has so much Lycra in it or something, and Lycra just completely seizes up in the dryer. I did wash all of these on cold water, regular cycle, and I also dried them on like just dried them on low temperature. So it wasn't no heat. It wasn't lay flat to dry. I didn't follow any of those directions. I treated them all the same and threw them all in the wash and the dryer just to see what would happen. I didn't have anything to lose. So I was like, let's see. So maybe if you didn't dry this with heat, you might have different shrinkage results. I'm not sure. But in terms of the stretch, it is still just as stretchy. The recovery is just as nice. The quality of the fabric feels the same. It feels, yeah, I mean, maybe the texture, like these little black dots became more pronounced in the, after being washed. Yeah, definitely. I mean, you can feel the bumps here and you cannot really feel them here at all. Softness wise, it's just as soft, just as lovely. Softness wise, drapiness is the same. So just a lot of shrinkage. You can even tell that the dots are like closer together on this one than they are on this one. That's so interesting. Okay, this was just a cotton shirting, I believe. I believe it was just the first one. Yeah, the Oxford pink, the Oxford shirting in solid pink. Let me put this guy back. He's got out of order. And again, I just wanted to see what would happen to the cotton. To be expected, lots of unraveling of the threads, but you can see, I guess this is technically a chambray, because isn't a chambray when you have colors going one way and white going the other way?
I swear that I read or heard Indy So saying something about that recently. Anyways, you can definitely see pink over here, white over here. Anyways, and then in terms of like feel and texture, yeah, it feels a lot more like cotton. You can tell whatever coating is on this has been washed off. It's not as soft, to be honest, if I'm being honest. It feels better unwashed, but it does just have that 100% cotton feel. If you like the way cotton feels, then you'll like this. It's just not blended with anything to make it super soft. It's just how cotton is. But yeah, there is a little bit more texture to it for sure. And the colors kind of stay the same, just as vibrant of a color. Yep. Okay, here we go. This is the, gosh, one of the plaids. Let me see. It is 11132. And that is shirting. It's just a plaid shirting. So you can tell, at least I can tell, that the colors faded a little bit. Don't you think? I mean, doesn't that orange look a lot less orange here? Yeah, 100%. Unless it's supposed to go like this. And that's, well, no, that doesn't make any sense. I don't remember how the puzzle piece went together. Maybe like this? Yeah, maybe like that. So those colors look pretty close to each other. So this is just a different colored stripe. Okay, I was gonna say, wow, that is a lot of fading going on. But no, not so much. Not so much. And again, it's softer than the Oxford shirting for sure. It's just lighter weight, I feel like. Thinner. So yeah, it's softer than what this is. But the before and after, in terms of weight and stuff, it's pretty much the same. This had really no change at all. It didn't even really shrink a lot. So if that's your speed, then go for this one. I feel like after feeling these feel like they changed a lot now. There's like a way bigger difference in these two than there is in these two. Just really in texture mostly. So that feels a lot more like raw. And this feels about the same. Okay, so this is the lace-covered denim, 11120, and I was super interested to see what was going to go on with this guy. Again, I just washed in the regular wash and dried on low heat, so I didn't do anything special with this whatsoever. I half anticipated for the lace to come off completely, but that didn't happen. You can see it's still very much intact. I want to say the blue in this one, the lace is actually lighter and brighter, and there's more of a difference between the background and the lace. More of a difference between the denim and the lace here. So that's kind of cool. It did soften up a little bit. You can tell the edges are kind of curled. And you know, it's wanting to have like some body, which is kind of interesting considering this is like flat as a board. But yeah, the color is definitely the biggest change. Shrinkage wise, it did shrink a little bit, maybe a quarter of an inch. So, you know, to be expected with denim, I guess. But yeah, it's that color. That's the biggest difference for sure. Yeah, you can even see it on camera really well. Cool. Okay, this is just a dot shirting, I believe. Let me double check. 11054. Denim stretch shirting dot blue. Yeah. So again, not much change in this at all. It feels the exact same, looks the exact same. It is wanting to curl, but that's probably because it was just maybe a smaller piece. I don't know why it's curling like that. Eek. Let me just hold that down. So yeah, it does have a little bit more drape to it, but not much. I mean, really, it didn't change hardly at all. So a little bit of shrinkage there. The dots are still fine. You know, sometimes with these printed on dots, they'll fade really funny. Actually, now that I'm looking at it, the color here is more vibrant than it is here. This almost, now I can see a coating on it. I can see like, you know, like when you put Elmer's glue on your skin and it has that, remember you used to do that in grade school, then you peel it off anyways. And you know how your skin would look whenever the glue would dry on it? That's what that looks like. And this doesn't have that at all. This is really, really pretty. So very nice. Excellent. Excellent. This is the window pane 11051. Stretch sateen. So you can tell what this was before and now after. This is what it's like. Much softer, even a little bit drapier in a way. It did catch a bunch of fuzz, so get your lint roller ready. If you have dogs or cats, maybe not the best option for you. There's a lot sticking to this. But yeah, it's just mostly, it's just softer. And like a little bit drapier. You can see how it's falling over my hand here in this one. And not so much in this one. It's pretty much flat. So yeah, the satiny part of it, the smoothness of it, I would say is pretty much all gone. I mean, you can tell there's something in there with the cotton, but not much. Okay, so this was the one that she was commenting on that I read from her email earlier in the video, 11224. The printed twill that she thought would make great pants. So you can see what happened to that in the wash. Actually, not much. It did shrink some. You can tell the difference in the width there. Oh, and the length. Wow, look at that. That's so amazing. You don't realize it when you're washing huge, yards of fabric, but yeah, I mean, it definitely shrunk up. The colors are still just as amazing, just as vibrant, just as gorgeous. It feels pretty much the same. It does have a little bit of a real satiny feel on the unwashed one that kind of goes away, but it's not something that you are going to miss after you wash it because it still feels really nice in and of itself. It just doesn't have that coating on there. But yeah, I love how vibrant the colors are still. That's amazing. So yeah, this one's great. Great quality. Awesome. Plenty of stretch still. And yeah, knock out some pants. Michelle recommends pants for this. Maybe ultimate trousers. Something kind of simple and streamlined. Cool. Okay, just a couple more here. We have 11129. 11129. And it's a gingham check shirting. Again, not that much of a difference here. The colors are still great. The didn't shrink a ton either, like hardly at all. That's really cool. It does have like more texture to it, which I actually prefer a lot more this than this. This to me feels kind of flat and I don't know, like, just uninteresting, but this is really nice. This is very inspiring to me to see this. I love the texture on it so much. It feels more summery. It feels, not the way that it looks, but the way that it feels. You know, it feels like you want to have it against your skin, whereas this one, I don't know, I was feeling papery, I guess it was the best way to explain it. It is still pretty sheer. Like, can y'all see those numbers through there? No. But I can see the numbers through the lighter colors. So that didn't change. Not that it would. If anything, it would get more sheer. I wouldn't say that happened. But yeah, the texture is just a lot nicer. I just like the naturalness of cotton, I guess. So it's not so papery. It's nice. Really nice. No real change. I mean, slight change in the drape, but not much. Okay, and then our last one here is that one or seven? 11134 possibly? Let's see. Yeah, shirting plaid. Again, another shirting. So I don't know why I did so much of these. I guess because I thought that they were going to shrink a bunch, but some of them are and some of them aren't. This one did a little bit, whereas y'all saw this one didn't at all. So, you know, what can you do? But this one, the colors are still just as great. Again, with the texture, just so much better after you wash it. Do you guys pre-wash all of your fabrics? I mostly do. There might be some, like, of this batch. Like, I probably wouldn't have pre-washed the denim or maybe this window pane. But yeah, definitely all the cottons I do or would have. And I recommend that you do. You think that this feels better and new and like you don't want to mess with like the newness of it and the smoothness of it. But honestly, it looks 1,000 times better when you have that texture of the real cotton and the weave and you can see all those colors woven in together. Like it just comes alive in a way. It sounds hokey, but that's like the best way that I can explain it. It's just a lot better. So yeah, I mean, if you aren't pre-washing at least your cottons, you know, at least you should do that. So yeah, there you have it. There is our updated follow-up to the swatches. So you guys could see how some of them reacted to the wash. I hope that you guys enjoyed this and that you could learn a little something. I know I couldn't redo them all because I can't have another hour and 15 minute long video. That's just crazy. So I just picked a few of my favorites or a few that I thought would be most interesting. And honestly, a lot of them surprised me. So I hope that they did for you too. And if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And subscribe if you haven't already. I know that there's been a lot of sharing and we have a lot of new people at the channel from the blog tour. So welcome and thank you. And if you want to make sure to see all my other videos, you have to click the subscribe button to do that so you never miss one. But that's going to do it for me. I will see you all very soon. Bye.